What the hell that mean? Huh?
So this is where it all began. Paul Lauterbur, the creator of the MRI, magnetic resonance imaging machine, which uses magnetism to look inside of your body. Paul used a radio frequency transmitter and receiver to send and receive radio signals. Its main magnetic coil creates a uniform magnetic field, and the X, Y, and Z magnetic coils create varying magnetic fields from left to right, top to bottom, and from head to toe. How does it work? That's the big question. Magnetic resonance imaging uses the body's natural magnetic properties to produce detailed images from any part of the body. For imaging purposes, the hydrogen nucleus, a single proton, is used because of its abundance in water and fat. The hydrogen proton can be linked to the planet Earth, spinning on its axis with a north-south pole. In this way, it acts like a small bar magnet. Normally, the hydrogen protons, bar magnets, spin in the body with their axes randomly aligned. But when the body is placed in a strong magnetic field, such as an MRI scanner, the protons' axes all line up. The MRI scanner, in other words, can be used to emphasize particular tissues or abnormalities. A different emphasis occurs because different tissues relax at different rates when the transmitted radio frequency is switched off. There are no known biological hazards of MRI because, unlike X-ray and computed tomography, MRI uses radiation in the radio frequency range, which is found all around us and does not damage tissue as it passes through. The only thing that could possibly hurt you is if you have metal or any kind of magnetically charged object near you. This all comes back to Paul Lauterbur, who shared the Nobel Peace Prize with Peter Mansfield for his work which made the development of magnetic resonance imaging possible. Lauterbur taught as a professor at the University of New York at Stony Brook from 1963 until 1985. That is when he began conducting his research for the development of the MRI. After moving to the University of Illinois to be a professor in Urbana, Illinois, he died in March of 2007 of kidney disease where he lived. The chancellor of the university said, "Paul's influence is felt around the world every day, every time an MRI saves the life of a daughter or a son, a mother or a father." The MRI is still used today. It's used all around the world and saves very many lives. Thanks to this man and his machine, we can find what truly lies beneath the skin, wreaking havoc upon our bodies without using surgery, so we can take it out before it gets even worse.